Hi, CLI family. My name is Norma Walker. You are probably used to seeing me behind the keyboard, but this evening I'm behind my kitchen table here, and I'm going to share a devotional with you on forgiveness. It's very important. I know that probably all of us as believers, we've all hit up against this wall, and it's very, very necessary. In Matthew 6, Jesus says that if we don't forgive others, then we will not be forgiven. So I just want to talk a little bit about sometimes what that looks like. I don't know if you've ever had this happen or if you've ever even thought about doing this to someone, but I had someone call me one evening, this has been about 30 years ago, and proceeded to tell me that they had forgiven me for this big long laundry list of things that I had done to them that I did not know about. And I was secretly thinking, you know, I see this for what it is. It's very transparent. You are angry with me and you want to let me know, but you're going to dress it up as forgiveness. So don't ever do that. It's so ugly. Sometimes when you forgive someone, it does require going to them and telling them and working it out. Sometimes, though, it's not. It's maybe better not to go to them and kick the beehive and stirring up all this stuff and telling them that what you have forgiven them of, they may not even know it. That's the way I was that evening. I laugh about it now. It's kind of funny, but at the time I felt like I had been punched in the stomach. But the thing that we have to do, the most important thing, is step one, is confess that unforgiveness to Jesus. For unforgiveness is a bondage. It will hold you and grip you and make you bitter. But we need to confess that to the Lord and just tell him, Lord, I am so mad at this person. I feel like I hate them. And that's just being honest with him. Ask for his grace. It may not be an instantaneous work. It may take a while. I believe that's what Jesus meant when he put a number to how many times we are to forgive our brother. That doesn't mean that they come to us and do 490 things to us, maybe in one day. But every time that thought or memory of that offense pops up in your mind, forgive. We have to take it to the Lord and forgive. It may take time. It may be instantaneous. But if it's not instantaneous, don't give up. Please keep confessing it to God and ask for his help. He has never asked us to do anything that he will not give us the grace and the strength to do. He has begun a good work in us, will be faithful to complete it until the day that he comes back. So I hope this blesses you. I love you all. It's good to see you on Sunday. And I hope that you will have a very blessed rest of your week. Love you. Bye-bye.